Peter Dutton says he has no regrets in launching a coup that deposed Malcolm Turnbull because the government was heading for annihilation. Nine News has gone one-on-one with the Home Affairs Minister as he battles to hold on to his seat in Parliament.
In the northern suburban belt of Brisbane, a controversial Conservative is fighting for his political career.
Well, we better let you enjoy your morning too.
Both parties' polling has Peter Dutton just ahead in his seat of Dixon, but there only needs to be about 1,500 people switch their vote and he's out.
When people say that, you know, I'm this sort of right-winger or Conservative, what they're talking about is that I'm tough on borders.
But when it comes to changing Prime Ministers, the man who was the catalyst for Malcolm Turnbull's downfall wouldn't change a thing.
No, I don't have any regrets.
He says in August the government was headed for annihilation and now Scott Morrison is doing a good job.
People see him as not only a competent Prime Minister, but somebody that they can relate to.
But as urban electorates change, Mr Dutton's views on the climate have had to keep up.
Do you believe in the science when it comes to climate change?
I believe in climate change. I don't have any issue with that, but I want a sensible response.
His challenger doesn't buy it.
Well, I think he's had a questionable history on action on climate change, and his party certainly has.
Labor's Ailey France is hedging on climate too, this time the Adani coal mine.
Do you support Adani?
We have said all along...
Not where you. Do you support Adani?
Well, I support the Labor Party. I'm a member of the Labor Party.
Peter Dutton says the size of this challenge is overblown, considering he's been fighting in a marginal electorate since 2001. But even if he wins, Mr Dutton says his ambitions to be Prime Minister are on the shelf for now.
I don't think people trust Bill Shorten. I think they're suspicious of him.
His community will now decide if they trust Peter Dutton with three more years in Parliament. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.